Yeah.
Alright.
Here's some of our, the vets. Yeah, go ahead and say hi.
Hello, with you over here. Having a good time so far? Wonderful. Pretty day.
Oh, it's a beautiful fall day here.
Bet.
Couldn't be better.
We're glad to be here.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks.
I'm going to go down to the floor, I guess if you call it, to the stars, commemorating the dead of the war, the fallen. Here's the, as you guys were mentioning, and I mentioned before, the columns representing the states.
Rhodes, and he was in the Pacific Theater, and ended up spending some time, well, kind of in the Philippines, and then and kind of right on the verge of going into a few different battles. So we were really fortunate to come down and meet such a great guy and get to hear some of his stories.
You want to say hi, Arlen?
Yeah, how you doing? You know, I don't think most people realize us young guys going into the Second World War, how much we appreciated given the opportunity to serve our country. We were brought up to love a country ever since childbirth. And I'm on the verge of the slippery slope going down, and I still love the country. It's the best country we could possibly have. And thanks to most of the people, practically all the people that backed us up on this, it was an honor to serve the country. Thank you very much.
So 1943, Australia was a key port for fixing ships, for fixing the submarines, and they actually set up the 7th Fleet first submarines here, and it was that initial thing. So there was a whole whole flotilla of submarines here as well, plus minesweepers. They had a whole range. So just getting started with a quick one, I'm just going to show a quick video of where I am now and what it looks like now, and some that may be involved may actually know this whole region. This is just around the Brisbane City River that you can see now. So part of this is just some of the old port area and some of the old stores, which during the war was where they actually would dock ships and stuff as well.
That is the USS Alabama. Jared, can you hear me? And can you tell people what they're seeing?
Yeah, sure can. We're outside of the battleship currently. We were afraid of rain, similar to last time, and thankfully the sky cleared up. Fantastic day out. The sun is at a pretty rough position for the whole ship. Hopefully you can see the silhouette and some of the majesty of this vehicle. It's just breathtaking being in front of it. And the propellers on this, we talked about last time, but, you know, we talked about it here, I'm sure it's solid. Those propellers here are good, 10 feet high, on top of the back of the ship. I'm completely off on the map. Again, just wanted to say thanks to all the veterans, and I just hope that you guys enjoyed this little bit, and enjoy the rest of the day.
The tomb was actually placed at the head of the grave of the World War I unknown. West of this grave are the crypts of the unknowns from World War II to the south and Korea to the north. Between the two lies a crypt that once contained an unknown from Vietnam in the middle. His remains were positively identified in 1998 through DNA testing as First Lieutenant Michael Blassie, United States Air Force, and they were removed and he's now interred in his home, which was St. Louis. The three graves are marked with white marble slabs that are flush with the plaza. The north and south panel of the memorial block, the tomb itself, are decorated with three wreaths on each side that represent the six major battles engaged in by American forces in World War I. The east panel that faces Washington, D.C., contains the three Greek figures representing peace, victory, and valor. And the western panel is inscribed with the words centered on the panel, "Here rests in honored glory an American soldier known but to God." The tomb of the unknowns is guarded 24 hours a day, 365 days a year in any weather by the tomb guard sentinels. The sentinels, all volunteers, are considered to be the best of the elite 3rd U.S. Infantry Regiment known as the Old Guard, and they're headquartered at Fort Myer, Virginia. And for those of you who are watching the coverage last week of Hurricane Sandy, the guards are given the option to take cover during storms. They have quarters underneath the pavilion that is actually at Jimmy's back. The only other cover they have is that little guard shack you see right in front of the Sentinel. And they refuse to take cover during hurricanes. They believe that that their service is so necessary and so honorable that they will not forsake their posts even in the worst of weather.
Stephen Monaco as well. Stephen is helping in the efforts to bring more veterans their memorials virtually as well. Stephen, any parting words before we see the changing of the guard here?
No, just repeat what I said before. I so appreciate the service of all of you vets and all of our active military men and women for the freedom that you've provided, and it means so much. Thank you. God bless you all.
I think we should all remember just how young everybody was when they were doing this. As young as, say, 15 years old, the guys that lied about their age, and the and if you were 26 or 30, you were considered likely an old man in the Second World War. So let's just remember, these were just kids and right out of high school. So to be brave that young is quite something.
Quite something indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? I am Sergeant Kamani of the 3rd Infantry Regiment, United States Army, Guard of Honor, Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. The ceremony that you are about to witness is the changing of the guard. In keeping with the dignity of this ceremony, it is requested that everyone remain silent and standing. Thank you.
Thank you.
Alabama.